Are you looking for a cheap hosting provider with a nice user interface? In this iPage hosting review, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about iPage so that you can make an informed decision on whether they're the right hosting provider for you. I'm not going to waste your time with fluff content. Instead, I'm going to provide you value by showing you the most important results from my live tests, like the page load speed, uptime, and customer support quality. I also provide you with a live demo, so you essentially get to test out iPage without having to purchase it for yourself. And lastly, I will provide you with my honest recommendations on if or who should purchase iPage. I also have a special offer for you if you decide to pick up iPage through my special discounted link in the description below. I also have a free checklist on starting a successful blog for everyone. So stick with me to the end and I'll show you how to get access to this bonus. Now let's get straight into this review. After purchase setup and ease of use, right away from their homepage, you can see it looks very easy to navigate with their custom interface compared to the cPanel that a lot of other hosting providers use. The design is also very clean and simple looking here, where on the left side of the panel are all the different things that you can do, like access your WordPress website or access your email account and even your security and domain and name servers. Now let's see how easy it is to install and create our WordPress website. And to do that, from our dashboard, we click on WordPress, click on Get Started, Use Existing Plan, type in your site title, put in your email, username and password. Make sure you don't use admin in your username, as this will make it easier for hackers to get into your website. Now click on Install WordPress. And you can see the WordPress installation process was very simple. I believe it's more intuitive than on the cPanel. And how about installing an SSL certificate? All you have to do is click this one button. Let's encrypt, turn that on, and that's it. Now your SSL certificate is activated. It's that simple. But just a quick note to be careful of on iPage and the upsell is if you click on SSL certificate here, this will take you to the paid option where they try and make you pay $3 per month for the SSL certificate. So just so you're aware, don't go this option. The next thing I'll show you is creating an email account. So this one I didn't like so much because the top two options under email management is G Suite and Microsoft 365, which are paid options. They've hidden the standard options down below. But once you've found it, it's very easy to create your email account. You just click on the plus button, fill out your name and password, and now just click on create mailbox. And that's it. Very straightforward and easy to do. Overall, I would score iPage an 8 out of 10 for setup and ease of use. I really like that they have a super clean looking interface with custom shortcut buttons to install and create things instead of having to go to cPanel all the time. I did take 2 marks away from them because they don't guide you well when installing your SSL certificates or creating your email accounts. They tend to mislead you into their upsell a bit too much. Speed and uptime performance tests. So after I have installed the basic WordPress site, I went ahead and tested out the speed of the bare bones website using GT metrics. And the result is 2.4 seconds. This is not really a great start for iPage. The speed is very slow right out of the gate. I always expect barebone websites to be around the 1 second mark, so iPage is a fair way off here. But let's give them the benefit of the doubt here and laser in more on the next test. So now I would take it a step further and add some design elements to it to increase the page size. And don't worry, if you're overwhelmed looking at this, my course that I will provide you for supporting the channel will guide you through this step by step. I'm also going to install some free plugins to speed up the website. WP Fastest Cache, which is for the speed optimization, and ShortPixel, which is for image optimization. And lastly, I will install the free Cloudflare app, which will also increase the website performance with their CDN for free. This will make it more comparable to what you would do in real life. Just a quick note here, after halfway through installing my Astra theme, my iPage WordPress account froze. This ended up being due to the limit that was placed on my account from iPage. I must say, it's really disappointing as this is the first time that something like this has ever happened to me. They did increase the storage for me, but told me that if it exceeds again, then they recommend me to upgrade. So I was definitely not happy with that, as I've only installed one theme on one website, and that is it. But they promise an unlimited number of websites. This is now what the new website layout with all the new plugins look like, and the speed is now 3.5 seconds, which is just way too slow compared to the top performing hosting providers in my test, and they also failed Google's recommended site load speed of 3 seconds also. Now, I have been monitoring the stability performance of iPage with Uptime Robot and can report that their uptime for the last 30 days is a perfect 100%. In fact, they have not had any downtime for over 57 days in a row, which is very impressive. Overall, I would rate iPage's speed and uptime performance a 6 out of 10. Their speed just wasn't fast enough, so I had to deduct a lot of points there. Other shared hosting providers can give you speed performance twice as fast as iPage. On the positive side though, they are a very reliable host and their uptime was perfect, so I cannot fault them on that part. Here's a quick question for you. Do you think iPage's page load speed of 3.3 seconds is faster or slower than you expected? Let me know in the comments section below. Support. iPage provides 24/7 customer support through email, live chat, and phone calls. I would test them out by asking them these three different questions on live chat. 1. I would tell them that I have been infected by a virus on my website and ask for their help. 2. I ask them a quick question about their domain name renewal costs. And 3. I ask them if they could do me a favor and install an SSL certificate and Cloudflare for me, as I am a complete newbie and have no idea how to do this. Here are the results. 1. I wasn't really happy with their service here. They tried not to help me scan my website for malware, as I had to ask them 3 times, and then they were not able to help me resolve it on live chat. They had to instead create a support ticket, which took hours to respond with a report in the end. They also tried to upsell me at the end of the conversation, which was also very disappointing. 2. This was done very well, and they answered all my questions about domain name costs in one go clearly, and everything took less than 5 minutes. And 3. The support staff was willing to help me to a certain extent. They did try a few times for me to contact either Namecheap or Cloudflare instead of just helping me and guiding me. Also, they were confused and told me to install extra SSL plugins at the end, which was not required on my brand new website. They didn't do a good job on this one. With regards to their response time, I contacted them at 3 different times of the day to make sure I get an overall average and not just a biased fast response time during their off-peak hours. So the 3 times were 5 seconds, 2 seconds, and 1 second. The average of those 3 times turns out to be 3 second wait, which is definitely the fastest out of all hosting providers I have tested out so far. Amazing response time here. Overall, I would have to score iPage's support a 5 out of 10. Support overall was average. Their support staff's knowledge and willingness to help was pretty bad. They tried to upsell me at the end of a conversation too, which was really not good. They should be spending time trying to help me instead of selling to me. The only reason I still gave them a pass mark overall was because their response time was the fastest I have ever tested. At an average of 3 seconds, they are a second to none. Do you like the level of detail I'm providing you in my review so far? If so, make sure to let me know by liking my video and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more quality content that I will be releasing every single week. Pricing options. Click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It will take you to my special iPage discount page where you will get the best discount iPage is currently offering. I will be looking at iPage's standard web hosting plan in this review. Now you can see here, iPage's plan is very simple. There is just one plan only. It's called the Go plan, and it costs you only $1.99 per month. And in general, it's really, really cheap as you're getting unlimited websites for this plan, where normally hosting providers only give you one website on their cheapest plan, which is around $2 to $3. But iPage is giving you unlimited websites, so that's a good start. Some of the things that I think iPage is lacking in their plan is they don't provide you with free daily automatic backup, which is something I expect every hosting provider to give for free, as it is a standard feature nowadays. The second thing I believe they're missing is the custom cache plugin to improve the speed performance of your website. This is also missing. But for this price and unlimited websites, you can't complain too much. Now, the next thing to talk about is the billing period. iPage offers 12 months, 24 months, and 36 month plans. So you can see here, the longer you buy, the cheaper it gets, as it's only $1.99 per month if you purchase it for 3 years, but it's gonna go up to $2.99 per month if you only purchase it for 1 year. So what I always recommend you do, and what I always do myself, is I purchase the longest plan possible. as this will save you the most money, because when it comes time to renew, it's going to be at full price, so you'll lose money there. And iPage has a 30-day money-back guarantee. So now I would choose their Go plan for this tutorial to test them out. The next thing regarding pricing is iPage's domain costs. It is very expensive and I don't think you should purchase it from here. Even though you get the free domain name for the first year, it's going to cost you $17.99 per year for renewal after that, plus another $9.99 for domain privacy. So that's about $28 in total. Whereas specialist domain companies like Namecheap, which I use myself, will only set you back $13 per year. So that's less than half price of iPage. So the overall pricing score I would give iPage is an 8 out of 10. They are a cheap hosting provider, starting at just $1.99 per month for multiple websites. They do provide you with enough basic features to get started. However, I didn't like the fact that they charge so much for the domain name, but at least they offer you 1 year for free, so that's not too bad. I did take one mark off them, as they don't offer automatic daily backups on all their plan for free. I believe this feature is very important and should come as standard on all hosting plan nowadays, instead of paying a dollar per month extra for it, like with iPage. I also took another mark off them for not having a custom caching plugin, like A2 Hosting or SiteGround does. This feature would further increase the speed performance of your website, but is missing with iPage here. This is a quick note regarding my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up iPage through my link, then just send me your receipt to bonus@.com/dollar and I'll send you back access to my course right away. It's that easy. And if you want my free checklist on starting a successful blog, then go to the link in the description below to get access to that. Recommendation. Overall, I have given iPage an average score of 6.5 out of 10. They have a decent price with a clean and easy to navigate user interface. So this is my recommendation for you. Whether you're a beginner or advanced user looking for a cheap hosting provider with a customized user interface and don't care so much about performance, then I believe iPage can be considered. However, if speed performance matters to you at all, then I don't think iPage is the right option for you. Now, I think picking the right hosting provider is such a crucial step for your business, so getting it right is very important. So if after watching this review video, you think iPage is not the right hosting provider for you, then I recommend you check out this hosting alternative, which I know will do the job for you. But if you're happy with iPage, then go to this next video, and I'll see you over there.